Hello everyone, it's ScottJam20. This is more or less a channel update and prelude before the start of episode 50, part 1. So as you know, if you've read the video description of the previous episode, I've been on hiatus for the past month, so there are a couple of things worth mentioning. First, I'd like to say welcome to my new subscribers. It means a lot when I receive feedback on my videos, let alone earning subs. Thanks for that, and I hope you enjoy my videos. Before I started recording this update, I trained all the Pokemon, so they are now level 57, and my Blaze is level 58, as you can see right now. Their movesets haven't changed since I gave all the Pokemon new attacks in episode 48. Although Mon Blaze was trying to learn Fire Blast at level 57, I ended up keeping Flamethrower instead. That pretty much wraps up this update prelude. Welcome back to Flora Sky, everyone. It has been a while, but I think it's about time we take on the Elite Four. So without further ado, let's head over here and speak to these guards. And apparently we have to show that we are worthy to challenge the Elite Four, which we are. We have all 8 badges. And cue the triumphant music. Yeah, I know. Bit tacky and corny, but hey. I'll take what I receive. So Freya's going to be leading on in the first battle against Bertha, the ground type trainer, or Elite Four member. There she is. Yada yada yada. Okay, Elite Four, after 1 month of not uploading. I know I was on hiatus, study hiatus, but let's begin. So, Bertha's first Pokemon is going to be Whiscash at level 52, and it's holding a Lumberry. It's a water and ground type with the moves Earthquake, Surf, Sandstorm, and Rest. Now, let's see if all this training has paid off. Let's see Giga Drain and hopefully get a one-hit KO. One. Wheel it down. There we go. Pure Ownage. As expected. Good job, Freya. So next up is going to be Crocodile, and that's at level 55, and that's the strongest Pokemon. It's holding the leftovers with the moves Earthquake, Rock Slide, Crunch, and Outrage. You do not want to let Crocodile use Outrage because it will just obliterate your team. But with the cost of actually confusing itself, other than that, just watch out. So I'm going to go in with a Surf, and if you remember in a previous episode, I obtained a Choice Band, so I made Rio hold this item. So Surf's power is going to be increased every time, at the cost of only Rio being able to use Surf and not, say, Ice Punch or Waterfall. I know Bertha is going to use one of her full restores. Yeah, I knew that was going to happen. But to no avail, because Rio is fast, and it'll be able to take out Crocodile with one more Surf. If this isn't a critical hit, and it isn't. Yeah, you eat them leftovers. Gonna get knocked out right about now. There we go. Crocodile's down. This Elite Four battle is going very smoothly, I think. So next up is Golem. I'm going to stick with Rio. And Golems at level 54, and it's holding a Citrus Berry with the moves Earthquake, Brick Break, Sandstorm, and Explosion. And doesn't pose much of a threat, because Ryokan is taken out, since it is a Rock and Ground type, and Golem's down. Now, this is going to be a problem, because Ryo can only use Surf, it can't use Ice Punch, because it is Glide Core, Ground and Flying type. Even though I think Ryo can take out Glide Core with one Surf, I'm just going to, you know, mix it up a bit. So I'm going to go with Spooks. Why not? Glide Core is at level 54, holding the Citrus Berry, with the moves Earthquake, Rock Slide, Aerial Ace, and Signal Beam. So I'm just going to start out with a Psychic. Don't know how much damage it will do. Not bad. And now what I'm going to do is hope that Boots can land the Hypnosis. Yes. Good job. And I've been having some real fail moments when Spooks fails to use Hypnosis. And now let's begin to Dream Eat. Oh no, I have a sneaky feeling that Bertha is going to use... Oh, tell a lie. I was thinking he wouldn't do that much damage, but Spooks took it out. So that is another Pure Onage win. Bertha's final Pokemon is Swampert. So I'm gonna risk it, I'm gonna send out Priya. Swampert's at level 54 and it's holding the leftovers, water ground type, just like Whiscash, with the moves Earthquake, Ice Beam, Curse and Rest. I'm really a bit wary about using Priya because it can use Ice Beam Beam. I don't know what's going on here. And it can take out Priya, so hopefully it'll use something like Curse. I don't know. Yes. Am I a mind reader or what? Come on. But Bertha's going to use a full restore, a second and final full restore to be more precise. And there you go. But I think we've got this match done and dusted. So I feel I used Giga Drain once. And then the final time. Could have got the critical hit, but oh well. You can still take our Swampert. Yeah, eat them leftovers. The Priya is faster than you. And yep. This is what you've been waiting for a whole month. A Pure Onage win. None of the team have fainted. And that's it. You defeat Bertha, the first member of the Elite Four. Yeah, most impressive. Thank you very much. And naturally, with the amount of money you receive, you should have received 5,500. Since your strongest Pokemon was level 55, but I'm just complaining there. No need to. So let's head on to the next room. And it is Adeku, or Older. Older, or Older. I don't know how you pronounce it, but Adeku is the Japanese name. So let's get into it. Ha ha ha. I'm Adeku of the Elite Four. Yes. Yes, I'll give you a good match. Okay, the second Elite Four member. Adeku. AKA Older. Older. I don't know. So he starts out with a Hihiguruma. AKA Darmanitan at level 54. Holding a Citrus Berry with the moves Earthquake, Facade, Heat Wave and Close Combat. This isn't a good matchup. I know I should have switched out beforehand and probably healed up Ryo. So this isn't going to end well. But we'll see how it goes. Yeah. Come on Ryo, survive it. Survive it, please. Yes. Good job. I need to heal up. I should have healed up off screen. So, healing up Ryo, use your close combat, it will take some heavy recoil damage, So I'm going with, wrong button there. I'm going with a surfer waterfall. What do you think I should go with? Yeah, go with a surf. And take out this Star Manitan. There you go. Nothing too difficult. Next up is Typhlosion at level 56. So a very high level Pokemon right there. And he's holding a Papaya Berry. So that raises special attack. So I'm going to send out Sandraco now. And its moveset is Eruption, Sunny Day, Solar Beam, and Blast Burn. Now, Blast Burn is one of the most powerful fire-type moves. But Sandraco is unfazed because it will use an Earthquake. And hopefully take it out. Which it does. Wow. Sandraco, you just own. Seriously. Next up is Blaziken. Also at level 56, so I'm going to stick with Sandraco. And Blaziken is holding a Lumberry with the moves Brick Break, Dynamic Punch, Aerial Ace, and Fire Blast. And Sandraco, Earthquake please. And there you go, 1-8 KO yet again. Okay, this is getting embarrassing for old air. I mean, Pokemon are going down like flies. They're dropping. They're just going down. So his next Pokemon is Infernape, also at level 56, holding the leftovers with the moves Mach Punch, Thunder Punch, Close Combat, and Heat Wave. And as per usual, another Earthquake. And will it take it out? Of course he will. Infernape's down, and oh well. The team's almost done. Done and dusted with Adeku. His final Pokemon is his Volcarona, his strongest Pokemon at level 58. Holding a Citrus Berry, so I'm going to send out Rio. But Rio's actually a bit flagging here. It's lost quite a lot of health after that close combat by Darmanitan. I have confidence in Rio's abilities, so I'm going to see. Let me check something. 1 minute. Just want to check out Rio's stats. Its attack is more, so you would expect Waterfall to knock it out. So let's see how much damage it will do. Not bad. Oh no. Oh yeah, the Flame Body. I should have anticipated. Oh no. Oh no. No. No, that was poor judgement on my part, and yeah, Rio's fainted. You go by! You dare! Don't be smirched! My team, after all our hard training, I send my Sandraco to restore the honour!
I couldn't have put it better myself.
The Sandraco, finish it off with a fly. I don't care. It's about the Flame Body. Just a simple fact that I'll be able to take out his Volcarona. There you go. That's the perfect vengeance kill, or faint. And I'll keep saying kill. I heard a lot of people say kill. You don't actually kill a Pokemon, you faint it. And Sandraco is up to level 58. So, awesome. I'll be defeated Adeku, aka Older. Older. Oh darn, I've gone and lost. And that's pretty much it for these first two Elite Four members. So next time on Flora Sky, after healing up the team off screen, we will be taking on the final two members of the Elite Four. I'll see you then. Goodbye.